To begin developing apps, you need to create a project in Android Studio. Mostly, we design in XML and write code in Java or Kotlin. If you haven't installed Android Studio yet, go ahead and install Android Studio from this link before you begin. I'm using version 3.2.1 at the time of recording. In this lecture, I will create the demo project for database creation and upgradation. Let's begin. Start Android Studio. In the Welcome to Android Studio window, click Start a new Android Studio project. In the Create Android Project screen, write Database Demo for the application name. For company domain, I am going to use sandipbhattacharya.com, which is my website. So the package appears in reverse order, that is com.sandipbhattacharya.databasedemo. Click the three dots to change the project location. I am going to save the project on my desktop. Just below the package name, you can see two checkboxes for including support for C++ and Kotlin. As we are using Java for this project, we can leave them unchecked. Click Next. In the Target Android Devices screen, keep the default values and click Next. In the Add an Activity to Mobile screen, select Empty Activity and click Next. In the Configure Activity screen, keep the default values and click Finish. Wait for Android Studio to configure and build your empty project. Run the emulator. As discussed in the previous lecture, we need to create a class that extends from SQLite Open Helper implementing onCreate and onUpgrade. Let's create this class next. Right click on Package, New Java Class. I will name it Database Helper. Select SQLite Open Helper as superclass. Click OK. Press Alt and Enter on the red squiggly line and implement methods. OnCreate is called when your database is created for the first time, otherwise it is not called. Creation of tables and initial data inside tables should be put here. OnUpgrade is called when the database needs to be upgraded. Use this method to drop tables, add tables, or do something else. It needs to upgrade to the new schema version. Press Alt and Enter again on the red squiggly line and click Create Constructor Matching Super. Keep only context as parameter. Remove all other arguments. We will pass the other arguments in the super call. Next, we will create few static constants to hold various information for our database. Private static final string. Database underscore name. Equals to mydb.db. Private static final string. Table underscore name. Equals to contacts. private static final int. Database underscore version. Equals to 1. Private static final string. Key underscore row ID equals to underscore ID. Private static final string. Key underscore name equals to name. Private static final string. Key underscore email equals to email. Private static final string. Create underscore table. Create table. Table underscore name. Key underscore row ID. Integer primary key auto increment. Key underscore name. Text. Key underscore email. Text. Private static final string. Drop underscore table. Equals to drop table if exists. We will need the context to show toast message, so let's copy that in class level variable. Private context context. Next, let's change the constructor to match with proper variables. Database underscore name. This dot context equals to context. I will write a toast message from inside the constructor. Toast dot make text context comma constructor called comma toast dot length short dot show. Next, write inside onCreate try db dot exec SQL create table toast dot make text context, comma, onCreate called, toast dot length short dot show, catch SQL exception e toast dot make text context toast dot length short dot show. Exec SQL method belongs to SQLite database class. It executes a single SQL statement that is not a select or any other SQL statement that returns data. If the SQL string is invalid, throws SQL exception. Inside onUpgrade, write try toast dot make text context comma onUpgrade called toast dot length short dot show db dot exec sql drop underscore table on create db catch sql exception e toast dot make text context toast dot length short dot show. Next, go to main activity and create an instance of database helper. database helper equals to new database helper this. Now call getWritable database method on database helper object. SQL database SQLite database equals to database helper dot getWritable database. From main activity, database helper constructor is called first, so the toast with message constructor called will be displayed first. Then the getWritable database method is called, which will call onCreate, as this is the first run of this app and the database is not yet created. So we will get the onCreate call message next. Run the app. Perfect. If you run the app one more time, you will see only constructor called message, as the database is already created on the first run. OnCreate won't be called again. Run the app. If we change the database version from 1 to 2, then we will get message in this order: constructor called, then onUpgrade called, and finally onCreate called. Because after the constructor gets called, the onUpgrade method is called, and from this method we called the onCreate method again. Run the app. Oops, we see one error message because of this. change the version number from 2 to 3. Run the app. Perfect. Now you may be wondering where to see the physical database file. I will show you that next. Open Device File Explorer via View, Tool Windows, Device File Explorer. Go to Data, Data, Package Name, Databases, where package name is the name of the package. Right click on the database and select Save As. Save it anywhere you want on your PC. To open this file, download and install DB browser for SQLite from this link. The latest version is 3.10.1. Now open the DB browser for SQLite you installed, click on Open Database, navigate to the location you saved the database file and open. You can now view the contents of your database. As you can see, the contacts table has been created. So, to recap, I have covered the basics of database creation and upgradation. Next, I will create a complete project to demonstrate all the basic CRUD operations. See you in the next video.